Alright, I'm back for a quick video. I did say that I would be doing or showing the run to Liabeze. However, I am already here. I did have a bit of difficulty getting here actually, largely because, firstly, that route that was plotted for me at the end of the previous video, it seemed to forget that one. It sent me somewhere completely different. And then I arrived in some anarchy system and was immediately pounced upon and interdicted by a python who was clearly a wanted criminal, because after scanning him, it didn't just come up python, it came up some bloke's name. And I did destroy him and got a bounty of about 33,000 credits for it, so that wasn't too bad. But I destroyed him in a highly unorthodox way. He more or less ploughed into me, took my shields offline, took my hull down to 20%, but because I'd already done a fair bit of damage to him already, he was destroyed, so I got the kill and the credits, but it meant that I had a repair bill of around 200,000, so I actually lost a hell of a lot as a result of that. So my balance is currently at 2,489,461, so it's actually lower than it was at the end of the last video. But we'll take a look at our trading. Our average profit is continuing to go down. 42,838 is the average. But here, this is where I'm going to sell my rare commodities. So let's see what difference that makes to my average. So we'll start with the Azure Milk. I bought it at 4,123 per tonne. I'm selling it for 21,436 per tonne, so I'm making a profit of 17,313 per tonne. So you know I'm only selling 4 tonnes, that's a profit of 69,252, total sale 85,744, thank you very much. Next one, Dizo Marcorn. Again, I only bought 4 tonnes. I bought this for 335 credits per tonne. I'm selling it for 16,177. So I'm making a profit of 15,842 credits per tonne, which means of a total sale of 64,708, 63,368 credits of that is profit. That's the kind of profit margin I like to work on. Next is Lavian Brandy. Now I bought this at 3,500 credits per ton. I'm going to be selling it at 20,580 per ton. So a profit of 17,080 credits per ton, and I've got 7 of them. It's not quite my biggest sale, but it's not bad. 144,060 credits for that. Profit of 119,560. Once it eventually authenticates it. There we go. And finally, Leastian Evil Juice, which I bought for 457 credits per ton. I'm selling it at 16,344 credits per ton. So a profit of 15,887 credits per tonne, and I have 9 tonnes of it. So it's not far off my best, but it's still pretty good. A sale of 147,096 credits, the profit of which is 142,983. Again, the kind of profit margins I like. So now, my balance is up to 2,931,069 credits. That's not bad. So let's see what that's done to my average profit. It looks as though, because I've already forgotten what my average profit was, but it looks as though it's gone down again. I can only assume it's because I didn't trade very much, or at least not in terms of actual quantities, but in terms of profit, yeah, it's very nice. So it now means that my current assets are 18,380,807. I must be bloody close to being able to afford the Type 7. Unfortunately, it looks like this system is another one of those that doesn't have a great deal, rather like the major systems in and around Seoul. There's only 5 ships here, and the Type 7 is not one of them, so I can't even check to see if I have enough. I'm pretty sure I don't. I think I need another 600,000 odd before I can afford one. But even before I get it, I will need to find a decent trade route so as to maximise the potential of the thing and make it worthwhile suffering what is almost certainly going to be a very slow and very sluggish and god-awful ship to fly, but hopefully it will allow me to rack up the credits rather quickly. So there you go, that's some pretty hefty profit margins. I mean, I have come a fair old distance. I mean, I bought them all from way up there, 176 light years away. At least the so lave Zeons also has rare items, but they are leathery eggs and they tend to be bloody expensive to buy in, and I don't think you're going to make that much on them, so I didn't bother with it. So yes, I had to go a hell of a long distance, but I think it was worth it. But now, as you can see, I'm right slap bang next to Achenar. Now I'm well inside Imperial space, and now it's time to start doing some missions for the Empire to get my rating up, and then hopefully get my Imperial rank on the move. So anyway, that's that one. It's just to show you that indeed the rare commodities are worth dealing with, especially if you are going to be travelling a fair old distance. So that's it. Yeah, this is Commander Lucosa signing off.